Hello beautifuls, this is Avrum here, and we're here with a new game named Plane Visual Novel. I don't know if it's Plane or Plane Visual Novel. I mean, it's a visual novel, so it doesn't even matter. But I'm gonna read you a little bit of the story, and then we'll get to it. Riley is a completely unremarkable woman. Riley, I believe, she is the redhead. If you were to ask her, a plane ride towards a job that could change her destiny ends in disaster when there's a critical engine failure during flight. It would be the end for Riley, too, were it not for a remarkable woman who claims to be from the year 2165. Yep, it's a time travel story, folks. And that is a little introduction of it. As always, I will leave the game below in the description for you guys to play. This is, I think it's a Yuri game. I'm not too completely sure. Watch the opening. Sure, let's go ahead. Watch it. Click here. Oh, shoot. It's going to pop up for me. On a different link. Oh, shoot, it is. Uh-oh. All right, well, you guys can watch the link. I would have watched it if it popped up in the game, but it did not. So we're just going to continue on with this thing. Planes. I hated planes. I've always had a fear of flying. There's not a single nice thing about the experience. Airports were confusing, going through customs was incredibly stressful, and then you're packed into a huge metal vehicle with other extremely unpleasant people like you're a bunch of sardines. You're expected to believe that a man-made hunk of junk can safely carry you from one country to another. But worst of all is a word, plane. Plane, plane, plane. If I were to describe myself in one word, it would be that exact one. Plain. I've never done anything special. I'm the type of person that slides through life without doing anything noticeable. My grades were mediocre, and my job as sous chef wasn't anything to brag about. By pure stroke of luck, I got accepted for a job as the head chef in a moderately well-known restaurant. Announcement. Good afternoon, this is the pre-boarding announcement for flight 265H to Paris. We are now inviting passengers to begin boarding at this time. Please have your boarding pass and passport ready. Thank you. Paris. I had to wonder how I got so lucky. I hauled myself off the bench, made sure to grab my small carry-on bag that held everything I decided to bring with me, and stepped towards the door to what felt like the rest of my life. After this flight, I would have a new start. I could recreate myself, be somebody memorable. I showed the flight attendant my boarding pass, along with a small nod with a smile, and walked down the cramped hall towards the plane. I hate flying. I took in a deep breath and through my nose, and took the final step out of the airport and onto the carpeted floor of the aircraft. Next was the search for my seat. Luckily, I was near the front. Quick to get in, quick to get out. I made sure to keep the long line of restless people behind me in mind while I hurriedly reached up to unlatch the overhead compartment and attempt to lift my bag into it. After a bit of struggle, I finally managed to slide the bag into place and took my seat. A window seat. It was always difficult to decide whether it was a good thing or not. On one hand, I could look out at the clouds and lose myself in them. I didn't have to pay attention to anyone else around me. On the other hand, the sky was a constant reminder that I was trusting my life to a plane. I looked out the window and let out a short sigh. It had been raining all morning, and there was no sign of letting up even now. I heard a shuffling and I turned to see a woman take the seat beside me. She let out a loud huff of air, then she followed with a loud brassy laugh. This is going to be an interesting flight. I peeked at her through the corner of my eye. If her outfit was any indication, she was a loud person. It almost looked like she was wearing a costume. Maybe she was a cosplayer. She looked over to me and gave me a huge grin. I smiled back, but she quickly turned to the screen of a small device she had been carrying. I wasn't too sure what it was. It didn't look like any cell phone or computer I had ever seen before. She glanced around the plane, and as soon as the last person took their seat, she stood up and walked down the aisle. The entire time she was staring at her screen, she walked back up the aisle to the washroom at the front of the plane and opened the door. I realized I was staring at her and turned to the window. Even though the weird woman was much more interesting than the asphalt that surrounded the airport, I still managed to entertain myself. The plane was relatively quiet for the amount of people who filled it. Would you like some peanuts? Hmm? I turned my head to look at the woman who offered me a small bag of roasted salted nuts. Oh, no thank you. Yes, please. The woman who was supposed to be sitting beside me graciously grabbed the bag and plunked back into her seat. The flight attendant seemed slightly taken aback, but she still smiled politely and moved on to the next passenger. Oh, she's cute! I turned my attention back to the strangely dressed woman who ripped open the bag of peanuts and dumped them unceremoniously into her mouth. She pulled the tray away. Oh, my character's cute too! She pulled the tray out from the seat in front of her and leaned on it with her left arm. Resting her face on her hand, she turned to look at me. Hey! And I expected her to talk to me, so her voice caught me off guard, and I stammered out a quick reply. Hi. What you going to Paris for? She still had peanuts in her mouth. I had to look away to keep myself from making a face. Work. Well, that's boring. I bit my lip and looked back to the window. Letting out a quiet sigh, I tried not to let the words sting too much. Boring. I figured I should at least attempt to keep the conversation going. It could be nice to have somebody to talk to after all. What about you? Oh. I'm not really... I tried to look at her through the corner of my eye without being too obvious. What does that mean? She shrugged, leaning back. She didn't finish her sentence. Leaning back while putting her tray away with her knee. One of the cheery flight attendants stepped up to the front of the plane and began her spiel about safety. Oh, that's a special. I wasn't really interested in what she was saying. This wasn't my first time flying. Apparently, the woman beside me agreed with my thoughts. She picked a piece of fluff off her glove and let it drift down to the floor. When she noticed I was watching her, she gave me a charming and quite beautiful smile. The flight attendant finished speaking and told us to put our seatbelts on. Within a few more minutes, the plane started moving and my stomach began to flip. The second worst part about planes is lifting off. It's almost like my stomach was going to turn inside out and I let out a small groan. Not a fan of flying. Not really. She chuckled and looked down around the plane with cheery eyes. You are? Max, and you? I meant... I let out a sigh, my eyebrows knit together. She was strange. I'm Riley. It's nice to meet you, Riley. Oh, likewise. Another laugh escapes her lips. At least she seemed pleased enough. I could have been stuck next to somebody much worse. Have you flown before? Yeah, I went on a few trips when I was younger. Nothing too special, just to visit family across the country. So this is the longest flight you've been on? By far. I've never flown before, at least not on a plane like this. That caught me off guard, and I almost asked how she was so calm, though so far she's deflected each question I've asked, or tried to ask her. Do you have anybody waiting for you in Paris? No. Traveling alone, it must be exciting for you. I guess, yeah. The decision to go to Paris was easy for me. I had no obligations to hold me back. I lived with my parents, never had a boyfriend, though I didn't really have any regular friends either. I am pretty excited for my new job. I muttered despite myself. I couldn't help but smile, a smile that didn't escape Max. Have you been to Paris before? Oh yeah, a long time ago. Oh, but you don't look that old. She answered with a laugh to shake off her head. I'm not. Do you think you're ready for Paris? I thought about it for a second. I mean, probably not. I don't really know much English they speak there. I don't even know how much English. Parlez-vous en français? What? Excuse me? That sounds like a familiar basic line. She laughed and placed a hand on her stomach. You're going all the way to Paris and you don't speak French. My cheeks flushed a soft pink and I bit my lip. I wouldn't worry too much if I were you, but it does kind of suck. Yeah, I guess I'll have to learn. No, I didn't mean that. I raised an eyebrow questioningly, but she turned her attention back to the strange device. She tapped the screen a few times, fiddling around with it and letting out a satisfied hum. You're safe, then. She muttered to herself and I knit my eyebrows together. What? She hummed again and looked up to the ceiling. I just meant, well, she bit her lip and actually seemed rather put off for the first time. It just sucks that this plane isn't going to make it. Oh wait, are you the person that's putting it out? My heart stopped in my chest. I had to force myself to let out a shaky laugh. Excuse me? That really isn't funny. I wish I was joking. She shrugged casually. See my hat? She pointed to the golden H that was sewn in the brim of her bright red cap. The H stands for historian. I am from the future and I was sent back in time to study this crash. So she was a cosplayer. a completely insane cosplayer. You probably don't believe me. She let out a playful sigh. They never do. Look, Riley, everybody dies in this crash. What the hell? I gulp, even though I know she isn't telling the truth. This is just a bad joke. I can't help but feel extremely nervous. This really isn't funny. historian from the future. Did you think I was stupid? There's no way that's true. I mean, the way she's dressed looks very futuristic. Even if it were, why would you bother saying anything? Because I like you. So you decided to scare me. I can take you back to the future with me. You don't have to die. The plane shook. I let out a scream and gripped the armrest of my seat tightly. Sorry, folks. Just a little bit of turbulence. Everything's fine. Max stared at the ceiling of the plane. It looks like she was trying not to laugh. She straightened her face and let out a small hum and looked me directly in the eye. It's going to happen soon. I have to go. You can come with me. Where are we going? She stands and walks to the washroom in the back of the plane. It quietly closes the door behind her. I stare after her, unable to rip my eyes from the bathroom door. I couldn't decide whether she was an extremely good actress or if she was actually telling a crazy truth. The plane hit turbulence once more and my heart stopped. I took a few deep, shaky breaths. It doesn't hurt to be safe, or she must be insane. Doesn't hurt to be safe, because she's obviously knowing what she's talking about. My hands tightened around the armrest of my chair. Was I really doing this? I can't believe this is happening. I look at the bathroom door again, and that was all I needed to jump into action. Better to be safe than sorry. I muttered under my breath and threw the latch open for my luggage. Miss, you can't! I'm sorry! I grab my bag from the storage and run towards the bathroom. Max, I'm coming with you! As I reached for the door, it swung open and a white-gloved hand grabbed me and pulled me in. I was enveloped by a blinding white light just as screams erupted from the cockpit. Just in time. I was just in time. Ooh, this place is cute! I rolled over and pulled a soft silken blanket closer to myself. Was it too much to wish for that all to be just a dream? Opening my eyes was enough to answer that question for me. Yes, it was. I let out a small whimper and curled into myself, clutching my pajamas. I hate planes. What was that? I slowly sat up and brushed the blanket off of me. It sounded like it was coming from right outside of the room. I took in a deep breath to calm myself and tiptoed over to the door. Relax, Riley. It's probably nothing. Gingerly, I placed my hand on the doorknob and turned it just enough to peek my head out. Riley! The woman from the plane yesterday standing right in front of the door, smiling broadly. Oh, Max. Good morning. More like afternoon. She gave me a wink. Oh, is that a feather right there? I don't know what that is. She gave me a wink and a small chuckle. Some jet lag, huh? I guess so. I let out an awkward laugh and she rolls her eyes playfully. When I stepped out of the room, I noticed a wall of pictures. Studying them, I realized they're all pictures of Max with a different person. I met her down the hall, staring at each picture until I got to the last one. That's me? Yeah, don't you remember? Right. She took a picture of us as soon as we got into the future. Max chuckles. It's a bit of a hobby of mine. Taking pictures. She hums and steps beside me, pointing to each of the pictures. Taking pictures with the people I bring back as soon as we get to the future. They make the best faces. You brought all of these people here? Yep. The future needs more interesting people. Though, she paused and frowned for the first time. Didn't all get to stay. Why not? I'll let Cecilia tell you all about that. Speaking of which, I need to get to work, and you need to meet my boss. I do? Yep, so get your cute butt changed. She gave me a wink, then walked down the hall, away from the bedroom. I turned back to the room I slept in, quickly changed into my regular clothes. This was unreal. I was never one to believe in magic or fairy tales. I never even believed in Santa. And now this? Riles! A playful voice came from just outside the door. Coming! I quickly slipped my cardigan on over my favorite plaid button-up shirt and stepped back into the hall. You ready? Not really. Nobody ever is. I gave her an awkward smile, not quite sure just what I was supposed to be ready for. Alright, we gotta go. If I'm late again, I'll definitely get another lecture. She walked down the hall towards what I assumed was her front door and swung it open. The city is going to blow you away. It always does. I trotted after her and peeked out the door, expecting to see a magnificent city. It's a hallway. Max laughed and walked ahead, leading the way to what I assumed was going to be outside. Right, Riley? Duh, she lives in an apartment. My memories from the day before were pretty hazy, but as I followed her down the hall, I remembered the building. Everything looked pretty normal, for being such an advanced future, that is. This is going to be weird for you. She had a coy grin on her face. Could she read my mind? See you downstairs. Wait! She stepped into a small bubble blue pad on the floor and disappeared. Max? I gulped, studying the pad. Is it a teleporter? Here goes. I held my breath, stepped down to the pad, and nothing. How do I get this thing to work? She could have at least told me. With nothing else to go on, I decided to use the only clue Max gave me. Downstairs? Oh, so you have to stay where you want to go? I'm enveloped in a bright blue light and the feeling of floating. As soon as I felt the ground beneath my feet again, I stumbled forward and slammed my palms into the hard floor. You've figured it out. I'm going to be sick. Max chuckled and extended her hands to me. You'll get used to it soon enough. Don't you have stairs? Well, yeah. But I live on the 42nd floor, so I'm not sure if you want to walk up and down. She pulled me up from my spot on the floor, and I can't help but gape at her. This building has 42 floors? Oh, I only live halfway up. There are 85 floors. I found myself staring at the ceiling. How? We need to head out now, or we'll miss the monorail? You have time travel and 85-story buildings, but you still have monorails. My eyebrow rose and she merely shrugged. It's fast. Come on, let's go. I mean, not as fast as teleporting. She turned to the front doors and confidently walked outside. Max, wait, how do the teleporters work? Whoa. Outside the doors to the building, I see a city larger than any I have ever heard of my entire life. The buildings seem to be hundreds of stories tall. The roads themselves seem to be in layers. The layer we were on was all sidewalk. People were walking or riding odd vehicles that seemed to be similar to bikes or skateboards. Above us looked like a road. I could hear the zoom of cars slicing through the air, and much above that, almost higher than the buildings even, was a rail. A large train-like vehicle crossed the rail at much higher speeds than any highway. Riley? I snapped back down to Max, and I realized that I had been gaping up at the city. This is... Whoa! Max chuckled and linked my arms in hers. I'd love to show you around, but unfortunately, I really can't be late to work. She sighed. Cece will seriously chew my head off. Cece? I'm guessing Cecilia. My boss, the one you're going to meet today. She's such a stick in the mud. She's a head historian. Her family practically created the historians. Her dad was the old head. Grandfather was one before, and so on. She's all work this and regulations that and blah blah. We're pretty much besties. Oh. Get ready. What? Monorail. Good. I was once again surrounded by the flash of blue light. The only thing that grounded me was the feeling of Max's arms on mine. As my feet touched the ground, I coughed, resisting the urge to empty my already pretty much empty stomach. When was the last time I ate? You alright there, Riles? Riles. Cute, right? She gave me a wink and waited for me to stand straight before dragging me forward again. Look, just in time. A monorail slowed to a stop just in front of us. The doors slid open and a variety of people stepped off. I was kind of surprised that I didn't see any aliens among them. Max pulled me onto the futuristic-looking train and found us a seat near the door. You don't need to pay? Nah, the thing is solar-powered and it drives itself so it's free. The future continued to amaze me. The monorail began moving. It was quiet and smooth. Not soothing, sorry. Nothing like a car, a train, bus, or any sort of vehicle from my time. This is amazing. I was more amazed by the plane. That 2016 had that kind of tech is just wow. Is that why you were so excited? Yep. I'm relieved. I was worried you were a sociopath or something. Max burst out laughing, which drew the attention of surrounding passengers. Her body shook and she brought her hands to her stomach. That's way too funny. I couldn't help but pout. What was I supposed to think? She let out a few more giggles and wiped away fake tears. Don't worry, Riles. I'm not a sociopath. I wasn't that worried. I muttered and looked out the window, trying my best to avoid eye contact. The sky was clear, and I found myself once again entranced with how beautiful and weird everything was. It was so green. There were a lot of plants around, and the different layers of city captivated me. I found myself wondering if there was even more below what I've seen. We're getting off soon. That was fast. Cecilia had me moved into an apartment that was close to work. She had me moved? Yep, there are houses and apartments that are made for historians and their families. It's an important job and such. I see. Cecilia put me close to work because she doesn't want me to be late or something. This is my stop. Oh, hey, that's the thing up here. Is that the teleporter? She stood up and I quickly followed her. There are a few others that wore similar hats to Max, but had a completely different outfit on than her. I had a brain fart. I was like, what am I reading? Hey, Max? Yeah? Do you not have to wear a uniform? Well, she's supposed to. Now, here's Cecilia. I guess Maxine thinks she is too good to wear her designated uniform. Cece, you came out to greet me? The tall woman sniffed and gave Max a glare. And this is where weird stuff for today. Oh, this is an interesting save thing. It's kind of cool. Really cool. But anyway, so far, this is an interesting story. Like, I'm very curious as, like, where is this heading to? Like, why... And each time zone, in each century or whatever, does... What's her name? Riley? No, Riley's my name. Max. Does Max save one person so then that way they can learn about that year or something? That's what I'm getting at, but I could be completely wrong. But anywho, the game's always in the description down below for you guys to play for yourself. It's free. It's not a demo. It's a full game. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Stay beautiful, and I'll see you guys in the next one.